Hello guys, well Lee here again. Well, it has been a long time, but today is the day. All of the pre-ordering of Megatron has been finally shipped out. You know, it has been a big weight over my shoulder for, almost half a year. So let's just talk about, make a video, talk about what happened during pre-ordering, why the delays, and how well they are received. You know, they are being called one of the best stores for what it designed for. And let's talk about what's coming in the, next video as well. So I guess let's start. Well, by now everybody knows that our Megatron is a big hit, and everything that we set out to deliver, it was delivered. There was only one small, issue that was the delay. So first, let me talk about what happened. How could we have like a 2-3 months delay after we tell you that we have a perfectly working prototype? So initially, we didn't expect this kind of success. So after the pre-ordering was great, and during it, every time that people talk about it, the more people join. And at one point, we sort of like, we already having so many pre-ordering, and we want to make sure that we are honoring and our promise and more. But why didn't we just start production right after the the money was received? There was a small thing like this. We have this power bank, which is a very good power bank, by the way, and this have an issue that it output 9 volts without the PD handshake. So for any device that was designed for 5 volt, charging with the low normal speed PD charging, that this thing could not withstand 9 volts. So first time it fried, second time it fried again. So I wish one point we didn't know what happened. So we have to send the power bank to the factory to be analyzed. And we have to decide if we want to go all the way to the, the highest PD possible on the market, or we just want to say, get rid of the feature altogether. And knowing me, I'm definitely not a quitter. So we went all out. So now we can do 20 volts, 3 ampere, 60 watt charging, which means even your MacBook, your normal working laptop, the newest one, can support the PD charging, and it can charge your Switch. It can also charge your phone, obviously, and your iPad Pro and stuff. So anyways, this whole thing caused a delay, and with delay, with more talk, and we figure out we want to make it a bit bigger than it was designed, because at the beginning it was like this, and the people say it's too narrow for your phone to be stacked, so we designed it to be like this. And afterwards we designed, we want to be like making sure that we get the best sound possible for what we can, for within the budget. So we started to play with the crystal oscillator, which was, at beginning was passive, then it was active. After, from the passive to active, the difference was night and day. So we decided, let's go all out. Since there was so much support from the community, we went with the temperature compensated oscillator and crystal oscillator, which was amazing. I mean, the result, you all heard it. So it was sort of like something we decided at last moment without actual, pay, and we just want to do it because we feel like we got the support, and it's only fair for us to give it back to the community. And after that, that was everything before that was like, yeah, 1 month delay, everybody's okay with that. But after that, China had all this power shortage, and the factory could not open. They only like normally it's 5-6 days a week for working. After the shortage, it was like 1-2 days a week for working, which was bad. But even that, everybody's like, "Oh, don't worry about it. We all know there is a power shortage in China." There was 1 month actual delay. But after that, which was even weirder, we had the biggest snow in my city in the last 100 years. My city has a lot of snow, but that one was really above everything else, and it was even on the international news. And we could not send our reference sample back to the factory, so they cannot know exactly how to produce them, and so we missed our slot. Because when you do have this kind of production with a factory, you need to arrange time, and they need to prepare the parts to be assembled, everything. And when you miss your slot, you miss your slot. That was actual delay. It was pissing me off. But at the end, you know, we really did it, and the result was really good. So I guess it's worth it. But during the whole thing, this time around, we decided to be more open about our date, but we won't be hiding behind our posts. I mean, I was keeping everybody updated in the group with posts, but this time we'll be doing videos to keep everything updated. I guess, you know, nothing is really bad, just maybe you see it from different perspective. I think we are learning things as we go, and the COVID is not good for the chip storage, and is definitely not good for the for the pre-ordering when it's coming to a time sensitive stuff. So this time we are definitely going to keep you updated in the format of, you know, video. So as a company who has been doing dongle and portable amp for years, you know, we were one of the first company who started the whole high fidelity dongles. But last time around, we want to do something different. We want to do a dongle that is huge. So it's called Mega Dongle. It's sort of different than everybody else trying to make dongle smaller. So for us, a dongle is anything that you can use with your phone without a requirement of a battery inside. And obviously, logically, we started trying to aim for something that with a battery, and that was too easy. Then later we went from this to this and to that. So the end result was, according to the reviewers, this is better than some cheap stack you get from, forgot which company. But anyways, the goal was to make the best source for our premium earbuds, because every time we got reviewed, it's always by those noob reviewer who has, you know, using their iPhone, or they're using their iPhone dongle, you know. So, but it's not just for our earphones. For all the big hands like SHP 500, 9500, all the various stuff that you find in the budget to meet tier section, the Megatron can drive it very well, even if it's just single-ended. But obviously, its true potential is being unlocked when you're using the balanced port. And also, I mean, rarely there are some really good IEM that's really hard to drive, like the Focom Pro. The best IEM, in my honest opinion, less than $300. Obviously, you don't hear this from all the reviewers because, again, they are reviewing with their iPhone. At the same time, the E5000, again, is very crazy hard to drive, but it's very good at the same time. So, I mean, the funny thing that we got is that the most funny thing we got, other than, you know, our international clansmen claiming this to be better than a lot of their super pricey the USB DAC amp, you know, like 10 times more of the price of this. And our local super VIP fans had decided that they don't need another DAP because Megatron is so good and it's so convenient, they can even charge the phone and well enjoy better music, you know, without having to charge their DAP. And that's why they decided, you know, they want to buy more Megatron, throw it everywhere instead of throwing multi-$1,000 just on another sort of so-called premium DAP, which again we'll talk about. And the most crazy thing is that a lot of some of our fans, not all of them, just one of our fans told me that he preferred our layout to something like this. This is like I don't know how much exactly, but it's more like more than $100 USD, pure DAC. And he said he preferred our, you know, simple line out to something like this. And that's sort of giving me good ideas on how the Megatron actually can be in the next chapter. So I guess that just covers up the reception we got. And we are very proud, but at the same time, it's only possible because your trust and support. For that, you have my thank you. So finally, our newest earbud, the metal MX500 shell, the master, not the make-believe metal, it's a real thing. And we'll talk about this in our next video along with the coming runabout event. I know you all love the runabout plus 5th edition, and I wanted to sell more, but I got lazy. But this time, really, this is the last time we are listing the remaining batch, and that's the end of it. And we're gonna have some new runabout coming as well. On top of all that, you know, finally some partner worthy of our runabout, even Defiant. So I guess stay tuned till next time. Bye bye, guys.